I, Vinita Gochar.
And I, Varsha Bhakri.
From River Mahanadi, are here for the induction presentation. So Varsha, do you know an actress addresses like this in a movie?
Yes. She was Vidya Balan, right? From a movie called Lagerao Gunabai.
Yes, you are correct. Do you know how she conveyed her message like this? What was the mode of communication?
She actually conveyed it through a radio. She was a radio jockey.
Yes, so topic of our today's presentation is Radio Mirchi, a case study of Radio Mirchi. Here are the contents of our presentation: introduction, marketing strategy, objectives, current market revenue, Indian radio industry, listenership analysis, conclusion, and the sources from where we get the information. Coming to the introduction part, Radio Mirchi was first launched in Indore. Actually, after 1999, when the liberalization took place, All India Radio was auctioned under the name ENIL, Entertainment Network India Limited. And in the first phase, it was opened in Indore on October 4, 2001. The CEO of the company is Prashant Pandey and the headquarters is in Mumbai. The frequency where you can switch over Radio Mirchi is 98.3. Revenue of Rs. 620.5 crores during the financial year 2018 and 2019. The objectives are to understand the current market demand of Radio Mirchi listeners. Actually, we have a dynamic environment and demand keeps on changing day to day. So it is necessary to understand the current market demand of Radio Mirchi listeners and to gain the detailed knowledge about the topic and to know the overall market revenue of the company. So, coming over the marketing strategy, it operates via city-wise programming. City-wise programming, like it have different programs for different cities. For example, Sunday Suspense, Coffee House Classics, Kolkata Express, and Nobody Not Out. Nobody Not Out is particularly for the Kolkata ones. And it also targeted housewives from 11 a.m. to 2 a.m. because it is a spare time of theirs. It has launched innovative and attractive shows for special days like New Year, Diwali, and Holi. So, I would like next slide to continue with Sasha.
Thank you, Vinita. So, Indian radio industry. This slide is all about the expansion of radio industry. Basically, my friend mentioned that All India Radio, during the time of privatization, that is in the year 1999, launched a new company called as Entertainment Network India Limited, under which Radio Mirchi was auctioned in the phase one. And it took over phase 2, phase 3, batch 1, and phase 3, batch 2. Now, phase 1 was held in 2001, phase 2 was held in 2006, and phase 3, batch 1, 2016, followed by phase 3, batch 1, 2017. So, it represents the competitors as well as Radio Mirchi took over the number of stations in these years. So the total 162 new FM radio licenses were allotted in phase 3 auctions, that is in the year 2017. Radio Mirchi acquired licenses in 21 new cities in the second batch, which was in the year 2017. And there is one more information that I got to know today itself. Radio Mirchi has also gone internationally in 2 cities, which is known as Clement and Columbus in US. The market size of radio industry across India in 2018 is 25.9 billion Indian rupees. The current market revenue, I have given it in quarter wise because the whole year revenue was not available, and I have compared the data, and finally I have got the whole year revenue, that is 620.5 crores. In the first quarter, it was 121.6 crores. Then it went on to 1 crore in the next quarter, that is July to September, 122.5 crores. And in the third quarter, 200.9 crores. It took 36% of increase. Later, it decreased up to 25 crores and 175.5 crores. Profit after tax, the profit of the company, which represents revenue deducted by all the expenses. So, 9.2 crores in the first quarter, second quarter 8.9 crores, and in the quarter 3, 16 crores. And profit after tax in the fourth quarter, 53.9 crores. Listenership analysis. This is the analysis that I have made, which represents the audience, the number of percentage of audience in various metro cities, especially, which are targeted towards a particular FM channel. So the main competitors of Radio Mirchi are Fever FM, Big FM, Radio Nasha, Radio Mirchi, Radio City, Red FM, and Air FM, and so on. So in Mumbai, the percentage share is 12%, which is color in purple color, which is of Radio Mirchi. And the other competitors, the main competitors giving tough competition to Radio Mirchi are Fever FM, Big FM, Radio Nasha, and Radio City, which are the same percentage. Bangalore share, 17% in Bangalore. Radio Mirchi is competing in the audience. 70% of audience is targeted towards 70%. Next slide. The Delhi share, that is 12%, and the other competitors such as Air FM Gold and Radio City, Radio Nasha, all these are the main competitors leading in Delhi. Kolkata is, in Kolkata, Radio Mirchi is the toppest channel, which is 19% share. Next slide. The conclusion will be continued by Vinita.
Coming to the conclusion part, in the era of digitalization, Radio Mirchi has still continued its consistency from 2000 till now. As all of you know that today, maintenance of consistency is the main part, as many companies vanishes from the market quickly. So Radio Mirchi has started from 1999 and it is still continuing from 2000, and it is still continuing with very easy earns merely through advertisement, as Radio Mirchi doesn't earn from the audience, so it basically earning is dependent on advertisements. Should strategize to convince the non-listeners to get more attracted towards radio, as all of us are dependent nowadays on mobiles, and as all of you know that iOS doesn't support FM radio, so we need to encourage the non-listeners to get more attracted towards the radio. These are the sources from where we get the information.
Thank you.
Thank you.